Madison do? He can do that. Well, he might be down to 10 men, but they are a goal up. James Madison swinging the ball in, Parsi.
Grant, what a good turn that was. Up against Ogbonna. Grant going for goal! He scored! Huddersfield have got three! He's got two!
Driven into the back of the net! Oh, it's Matt Ritchie of all people!
Aubameyang, Lacazette, settles it surely for Arsenal. There's the combination. And that's what they've been paying for, the crowd.
Madison going for goal! Absolutely wonderful. What a first season this is in the Premier League.
Taking West Ham on and on. Astonishing. Absolutely amazing. The typical of the man. A stroke of magic from a genius.
Still he goes. Oh, what a contribution it is.
Hello everyone and welcome back to episode 4 of the official Premier League pub quiz, the best quiz in the world right now. We are here every single week premiering the video 6 p.m. every single Sunday. So if you're in the chat right now, stay on your toes. I'm going to be asking you all sorts of bits and pieces in between the questions. Before we kick off, we just want to give a shout out to everyone who's playing along with friends and family online. We saw a tweet using the hashtag PLPubQuiz, which you should be doing right now. Get ready, take a shot, take a selfie, do whatever you want to do, but get it out there on social media. Let the world know that the best quiz in the world right now is the PLPubQuiz. But anyway, Charlie Roberts tweeted this. Strong outing in episode 3 with a score of 24 out of 38. 4-point increment from previous week from Melbourne, Australia. Playing along with Ozzy the Beast. Another reason why this quiz is so good, it allows you to flex on your mates as well on social media. The Boston United show tweeted this. Third week in a row I've beaten my dad at the Premier League pub quiz. Need to get better though. 8, 15 and now 13 this week. Bring on next week. That is the attitude. I like it. I'm feeling it. This is the week. Week 4, it's all going to come together for everyone. I can feel it. We've also got some eagle eyes. Bex15 saw herself in the quiz. In one of the clips, she's drawn an arrow here, pointing to herself. You've got better eyesight than me, Bex. Hopefully you're here today, ready to take on another quiz. I cannot promise you, though, that you're going to be in the background this time. But if somehow you do see yourself again, let us know. Right guys, here we go. Let's get into this quiz. There's gonna be 5 rounds, 5 questions per round and 38 points in total. Make sure you've got a pen and paper ready and we will dive into the questions. We're gonna go through all of the questions, then we're gonna circle back round and I'll give you all the answers. So take your time and just focus on getting the answers right. I'll give you a tiebreaker question as well. Then we'll come back round and I'll give you all the answers. We will kick off with round 1, which of course is the multiple choice round. Nice and easy, giving you a few options, 5 points available. Let's do this. Question 1. I'm going to give you 4 multiple choice options here. Who is the highest scoring Dutch player in Premier League history? Who is the highest scoring Dutch player in Premier League history? Good luck, guys. We're off and running. That is the first question. The options are A, Dennis Bergkamp, B, Robin van Persie, C, Jimmy Floyd Hasselbank, or D, Ruud van Nistelrooy. We're into it now. The first question. Who is the highest scoring Dutch player in Premier League history? Is it A, Dennis Bergkamp, B, Robin van Persie, C, Jimmy Floyd Hasselbank, or D, Ruud van Nistelrooy? All prolific goal scorers, all great forwards in the Premier League era, but who has scored the most goals? Question 2. Who provided the most assists in the 2018-19 Premier League season? Last season, who provided the most assists in the Premier League? In 2018-19, was it A, Trent Alexander-Arnold of Liverpool, B, Christian Eriksen of Tottenham Hotspur, C, Ryan Fraser of Bournemouth, or D, Eden Hazard of Chelsea? Which one was it? Who provided the most assists in 2018-19 in the Premier League? Was it A, breakout season really for Trent Alexander-Arnold when it came to assists? B, Christian Eriksen, prolific when it comes to assists for Tottenham in his time there. C, Ryan Fraser, a really strong breakout season for him. Great partnership with Callum Wilson there. Was it him? Or was it D, Eden Hazard? Question three in the multiple choice round. Who were the two other Manchester City scorers before Sergio Aguero's last minute winner against QPR won them the 2011-2012 Premier League title? I was at this game. I wasn't in the Man City end, I was down in the QPR end. QPR just survived that season by the skin of their teeth, despite losing this game. The options were A, Pablo Zabaleta and Mario Balotelli, B, Pablo Zabaleta and Edin Dzeko, C, David Silva and Edin Dzeko, or D, Julian Lescott and Carlos Tevez. So let me give you that question again. Who were the two other Manchester City goal scorers before Sergio Aguero scored that last minute winner against QPR to win them the title in 2011-2012? Was it A, Pablo Zabaleta and Mario Balotelli? Was it B, Pablo Zabaleta and Edin Dzeko? Was it C, David Silva and Edin Dzeko? Or was it D, Julian Lescott and Carlos Tevez? The game finished 3-2. Of course, Aguero got the last minute winner, but who got the two goals before that? Question four, who is the youngest player to score a Premier League hat-trick? Who is the youngest player to score a Premier League hat-trick? Is it A, Chris Bart-Williams in April 1993? Is it B, Robbie Fowler in October 1993? Is it Michael Owen in February 1998? Or is it D, Nicholas Anelka in February 1999? Who is the youngest player to score a Premier League hat-trick? I'll run through them again. Was it A, Chris Bart-Williams in April 1993? Was it Robbie Fowler, that's answer B, in October 1993? Was it C, Michael Owen in February 1998? Or was it D, Nicholas Anelka in February 1999? And the final question of the multiple choice round, the first round in this week's quiz, which team was not relegated from the inaugural 1992-1993 Premier League season? Was it A, Oldham Athletic, B, Crystal Palace, C, Middlesbrough, or D, Nottingham Forest? So three of these teams went down, one team survived. Which team was the team that survived? Which team was not relegated from the inaugural 1992-93 Premier League season? Was it A, Oldham Athletic, B, Crystal Palace, C, Middlesbrough, or D, Nottingham Forest? So that's the end of round one. I like multiple choices the first round. It's a bit of a warm-up for everyone. So if you're watching the premiere right now, let us know in the chat, how did you find that? And how did you compare it to previous weeks? Was it harder? Was it the hardest? Was it a little bit easier? Or are you feeling good? Are you feeling bad? Thumbs up or thumbs down in the chat right now. Let me know how you're getting on. Speaking of thumbs up, if you're enjoying the quiz so far and you're in the live chat and you want a shout out from the Premier League, hit that like button right now. If you can get ourselves to 300 likes, the Premier League will start shouting out you guys in the live chat. So get on that as well. Round two is the Who Am I round. There are 5 points up for grabs here, and this is a tough round. A lot of people have been saying on social media and in the comments that it's the Who Am I round where people start to struggle and maybe miss out on a couple of points that could stop them getting that perfect 38. So listen in closely. What we're going to be doing here is I'll reel off a list of Premier League clubs. There is one Premier League player who has played for all of those clubs in order during their Premier League career. All you got to do is identify the player, okay? So first question, who am I? I played for Manchester City, Chelsea, Bolton Wanderers, Chelsea, Liverpool, West Brom, and Liverpool. So this player, it could be a current player, it could be a player that's stopped playing now, but they've played for all of these clubs in the Premier League. Okay, they might have played for other clubs around the world, but they've played in order for these clubs. Manchester City, then Chelsea, then Bolton Wanderers, then Chelsea again, then Liverpool, then West Brom, and then Liverpool again. Who is that player? Question two, who am I? I played for the following clubs in order. Blackburn Rovers, Newcastle United, Manchester City, Aston Villa, Stoke City. So this player kicked off their career at Blackburn Rovers. Their first move was to Newcastle United. They then played for Manchester City, then went to Aston Villa, and then finished off their Premier League career at Stoke City. Who is that player? Tough one, that. That is a really tricky one. Good luck, guys. This is, you know, look, this is the Premier League pub quiz. You know, this is elite level quizzing that we've got going on here. They're not all going to be easy. If you're able to get that one, you're doing very, very well. Question three, who am I? I played for the following clubs: Everton, Manchester City, West Bromwich Albion, Aston Villa, and then Sunderland. Who am I? Played for Everton, then Man City, then West Brom, then Aston Villa, and then Sunderland. The only clue I can give you with this one is the fact that you've got to remember this is just in the Premier League, okay? This is just in the Premier League. I can say no more than that, okay? I wouldn't be doing my job as the host with enough if I didn't, if I said more, you know. Question four, who am I? I played for the following clubs in the Premier League: Manchester City, Birmingham City, Manchester City, West Ham United, Burnley. Started off my Premier League career at Manchester City. Then I played for Birmingham City. Then I played for Manchester City again. Then I played for West Ham United. And then I played for Burnley. Who am I? And question five, the final question in the Who Am I round. Who am I? I play for the following clubs: Manchester United, West Brom, Manchester United, Sunderland, Fulham, Aston Villa. Does that help when I move about? Who knows? Hopefully it is helping. Who am I? I played for Manchester United. Then I went to West Brom. Then I played for Manchester United again. Then I played for Sunderland. Then I played for Fulham. Then I moved to Aston Villa and played for them. That was the last team that this player played for in the Premier League. So that's the end of round two. If you've just joined us, don't worry. You can go back to the start of this video and play the quiz again in real time so you don't miss out on any questions. For those of you who have been here from the start, we salute you. And we also move into round three, which is the what happens next round. 5 points available here. We're going to show you some clips here. So if you're across the living room, in the kitchen, wherever you are right now watching this video, get in front of the screen. You're going to need to see a Premier League clip that we're going to show you. We're going to show you five, in fact. And we want you to tell us quite simply what happens next. We kick off in West London. Question one and clip one is from the game between Chelsea and West Ham in 2019, April 2019. Chelsea are on the attack. What happens next? So the cross comes in. That looks like Ross Barkley, who's going to be on the end of it. Something happens next. Can you remember? It was only last year, 2019, April 2019. This might be one of those questions where you need to pause the video. That's absolutely fine. As you know, when it comes to the Premier League quiz, unless you've just arrived during the premiere, then you shouldn't be rewinding at any stage. You can pause. You can pause at any point if you need that little bit more time to make sure you get the questions right, to give yourself just that breather. But you do not rewind. Don't worry, I'm going to show you the clip one more time in just a second. But if you do need to pause, feel free to do so. Okay, let's show you that clip one more time.
Double Chelsea's money. Hudson-Odoi.
We move on to clip two, question two in the What Happens Next round. It's from September 2002 and a very, very big game between Birmingham and Aston Villa.
Villa's 15th successive season in the top.
So it's a huge derby game. Melberg, Swedish centre-back for Aston Villa, is throwing the ball back to Peter Enkelman. What happens next? If you need some more clues, let's show you that clip one more time. Here you go.
Villa's 15th successive season in the top.
Can you remember what happens next? Have you seen this? If you haven't, maybe you need to check out the Premier League's archive footage. There's so many great videos, so much good nostalgia there you can just dive into in these unprecedented times. You just need to see some high quality volleys or goals or whatever you need. The Premier League YouTube channel's got you covered, and maybe you've seen this one before. What happens next? Can you remember? Okay, clip three in the What Happens Next round. We're gonna go way back now to the 19th of September, 1992. We're at Villa Park this time, not St Andrews. We're staying in the Midlands though. Aston Villa are playing Liverpool. Liverpool wearing that iconic green away kit. What happens next? Now, I know this is a long time ago, but this clip is so iconic. All big Premier League fans, surely you've seen it before. So I'm not even going to say the name of the player here. I'm not even going to repeat it. Because you should know this one. You should know this one. I'm going to be firm on this one. I'll show you it one last time. So that's your clue. We've shown you the clip. If you need to pause, that's fine. If not, we move on to the fourth clip, which comes from December 2004, and a game between Manchester City and West Bromwich Albion.
Right, Phillips. Now, Earnshaw could get...
20th of December 2004, Man City versus West Brom, a speculative ball over the top from Paul Robinson. What happened next? Can you remember? Let me show you it one last time. This one's a bit tricky, isn't it? Let's show you one more time.
Right, Phillips. Now, Earnshaw could get...
The final clip comes from the 3rd of February 2008. We're going to Craven Cottage now. Fulham versus Aston Villa. The managers and players are coming out for the second half. Let's show you the clip. All you got to do is tell us what happens next.
Oh, Villa going to... close in on the top four. It was about as good as the action got, really.
So that was Billy the Badger there, the mascot for Fulham. He's involved in this, I'm afraid. But how is he involved? What happens next? Let's show you the clip one last time. See if you can spot any clues. Be very eagle-eyed here. Have a look around. Okay, it's the last chance that you're going to see it. There is a clue in there somewhere.
Villa going to close in on the top four. It was about as good as the action got, really.
Round four is the connector dots round. 9 points available here. What we're going to do is we're going to ask you four questions. We want you to write down those answers. For each question, you will get 1 point if you get it correct. The fifth question is a bonus question, and what we want you to do is connect the dots. And by connect the dots, what I mean is connect the answers from the previous four questions. So the answers from the four questions before will lead you towards the answer of the fifth question, okay? 5 points if you can get that one correct, so 9 points in total. The first question is this. Which side has scored the most goals over the past decade? So throughout the 2010s, 2010 to 2019, who has scored the most goals? Which side? That is question one. Question two, which side won a Premier League record of 14 consecutive matches without conceding a goal in 2008, 2009? So in the 2008, 2009 season, there was a Premier League side that didn't concede a goal for 14 matches. Who was that side? Question three, which side went an incredible 86 home Premier League matches unbeaten from 2004 to 2008? Which side went an incredible, absolutely incredible, 86 home Premier League matches unbeaten from 2004 to 2008? That is a very, very good season ticket if you can get it. That's question three. Question four, which side scored in a Premier League record 55 consecutive matches from May 2001 to November 2002? So this is the fourth question. You're going to need to connect them in a second, but let's get this question right first. Which side scored in a Premier League record 55 consecutive matches from May 2001 to November 2002? So there you have it. There are your four questions in the Connect the Dots round. Hopefully you've got four answers. The fifth question, the bonus question, the question worth 5 points is, what do these four clubs have in common? So each answer, a bit of a clue there. The four questions that I've asked so far, each question, the answer is a club. But what do those clubs have in common? Make sure you guess. Make sure you write something down here, because 5 points. 5 points up for grabs here. Huge. So if you're not even going to have a go, that'd be silly. That'd be a waste of the quiz. You can get 5 points, even if you can give it a guess. If you've only got three answers, that's okay. Think about connecting the dots between those. And who is that missing club? Take a bit of time. If you need to pause the video, that's absolutely fine. I don't want you to miss out on these 5 points. So make sure you have a guess at least. We move into the final round, round five, the miscellaneous round, and there are 14 points available here. Question one is my favourite question of every single week. We put together, it's art, it really is art, three Premier League faces, and we merged them into one stunning face. And every week it's something unique and it's exciting. And it's also a quiz question. It ticks all the boxes. All you've got to do is tell us who the three Premier League faces are. So we've got the hair, we've got the eyes, the nose and the ears, and we've got the mouth and the chin. 1 point for every correct answer, but if you can get all three of them, that doubles and you get another 3 points. So 6 points up for grabs in total. Hopefully you can get all three of them right. But if you can't, make sure you get at least one or two here. What are you seeing there? You got luscious locks. Lovely blonde locks there. Solid eyebrows, and I can talk with these animated bad boys. You've got some little sideburns there. Is that just a, you know, is that a staple of this player? Or is that something that's just sort of through a trend of, in recent times? And then down the bottom there, you got those luscious lips of a Premier League face there. Who are those three Premier League faces? Question two, and it's time for our Fantasy Premier League question. And this week, we've got Jules, the host of the FPL show, to ask that question.
Yeah, hiya James and everyone taking part in this week's quiz. Here's my question for you. At the end of the 2018-19 season, who was the most owned player in FPL? Was it A, Paul Pogba, B, Andy Robertson, C, Raul Jimenez, or D, Sergio Aguero?
Thank you very much, Jules. So let me read out that question for you one more time in case you need it. At the end of the 2018-19 season, who was the most owned player in FPL? Was it A, Paul Pogba, B, Andy Robertson, C, Raul Jimenez, or D, Sergio Aguero? Question three, and it's time for some quick fire goals. This is one of my favorite questions. We're gonna show you a clip, and there's gonna be goal after goal after goal. We're gonna have five goal scorers in around 5 seconds. So make sure you're around the screen right now. Make sure you can see my face, because very soon, don't worry, you won't have to see my face. You'll be able to see some high quality and quick fire goals, okay? Are we ready? Okay. Pens and papers ready. Concentrate. 3, 2, 1. So there you have it. Very quick fire. It's very difficult. Don't worry. We're going to show you the clip again. So maybe pause the video for a second. Write down the ones that you've got so you can focus on the ones that you haven't got. I'm going to show you it two more times. So don't worry. Okay. Here's the first time. 3, 2, 1. You're close, aren't you? I can see, I can sense it, I can feel it. Okay, one last time. One last time, because we don't rewind unless we've just come to the quiz for the first time. We want to go to the start. We only pause. So we're going to show you one last time, because this is tough. This is tough. Okay, ready? 3, 2, 1. Question 4, and it's time to hear from a Premier League legend. Micah Richards, formerly of Manchester City, has got a question on that very club and his time there. Here you go.
Thanks, James, and hello to everyone who's tuning in. My question is, I made 179 appearances for Manchester City. Only one English player made more appearances for the club in the Premier League. Is it A, Joe Hart, B, James Milner, C, Sean Wright Phillips, or D, Raheem Sterling?
Thanks for that, Micah. So Micah played 179 times in the Premier League for Manchester City, the second most by an English player. But there is one player who has had more appearances in the Premier League for Manchester City. Who is that player? And question 5, the final question of the final round. It has flown by this week. Don't worry, we've actually got 2 questions left for you when it comes to the quiz. We've got this, the final question in normal time of the quiz, and then almost like extra time, we've got a tiebreaker in case you need it, because I'm sure you're playing your friends, your family, your school, your teammates, your mates from work, whoever it is, you'll be playing against them and wanting to beat them. So if it gets to a draw, we need a tiebreaker question. So don't worry, we've got you covered here at the Premier League. But let's finish off round 5 first with Spot the Ball. We love this one. Every single week, we show you a picture. In this picture, the ball has disappeared. We've taken it away. We want you to tell us where the ball should be. You've got to tell us the correct coordinates. You've got the numbers along the top and the letters down the side. So this week's Spot the Ball picture is from the King Power Stadium, the game between Leicester City and Watford. You've got Kiko Femenia and James Justin battling for possession. But where is the ball? Where do you think the ball is? You need to write down the coordinates. So that could be A1 or 1A, whichever way you want to do it, don't worry. Take your time. If you need to pause on the photo, just to give yourself a bit of time to understand the body language. See if you can understand where that ball is, which square it's in. Take your time, it's fine, it's good. I like it, you know, I like the sort of the duty of care that you're giving the quiz. That's what we want to see. Okay, once you've got your answer down, we will move on to what could be crucial. It could be everything. The tiebreaker question. So when it comes to the tiebreaker question, what matters is who is closest to the correct answer. So if you are drawing with different people, whoever is closest to the correct answer of this question, you get the point, you get the spoils, you get the victory, you get the W, which I'm sure you'll be sharing on social media using the hashtag PLPubQuiz. The tiebreaker question is this. Liverpool have scored the most penalties in Premier League history. But how many have they scored? Liverpool scored the most penalties in Premier League history, but how many exactly have they scored? Whoever gets closest gets the W. So write down your answer. What sort of number are you thinking? Let us know in the live chat. Obviously, we're not going to tell you the answer just yet. We're about to go through all the answers. But let us know in the live chat what you're thinking about when it comes to that. How many penalties? Well over 20 years. How many penalties? Could mean everything. Let us know. Right, that's enough questions. Let's give you some answers as we go back to round 1, which was the multiple choice round. Right, guys, we're going to give you some answers, but before that, can I just ask? I want to see some celebrations. I want to see them online. Use the hashtag PLPubQuiz. Get your phone out. Get it ready. Don't go to Google. It's too late for that now because we're going to go through the answers. But get yourself ready to take a picture of yourself. I want some celebration selfies using the hashtag PLPubQuiz. I want you to rub it into whoever you're taking on today. This is a competition. Whoever you're battling up against, someone's got to win. And if you are that winner, I want to see it. We will show the best ones on next week's quiz. Okay, let's do it. Round 1, multiple choice, 5 points up for grabs. The first question was, who is the highest scoring Dutch player in Premier League history? The options were A, Dennis Bergkamp, B, Robin van Persie, C, Jimmy Floyd Hasselbank, and D, Ruud van Nistelrooy. Very, very strong marksmen, all of them, but the correct answer was B. Robin van Persie, quite far out in the lead, actually. Dennis Bergkamp, 87 goals. Ruud van Nistelrooy scored 95 goals in the Premier League. Jimmy Floyd Hasselbaink, 127 goals in the Premier League. But Robin van Persie, 144 goals in 280 Premier League appearances. Question two, who provided the most assists in the 2018-19 Premier League season? Was it A, Trent Alexander-Arnold, B, Christian Eriksen, C, Ryan Fraser, or D, Eden Hazard? The correct answer was D, Eden Hazard with 15. Trent Alexander-Arnold and Christian Eriksen both got 12 assists last season. Ryan Fraser, 14. Question three, who were the two other Manchester City scorers before Sergio Aguero's last minute winner against QPR won them the 2011-12 Premier League title? Was it A, Pablo Zabaleta and Mario Balotelli? Was it B, Pablo Zabaleta and Edin Dzeko? Was it C, David Silva and Edin Dzeko? Or was it D, Julian Lescott and Carlos Tevez? The correct answer was B, Pablo Zabaleta and Edin Dzeko. Zabaleta put City ahead on 39 minutes before Jibril Cisse and Jamie Mackey put QPR in front, and then the other scorer was Edin Dzeko, which was really late on in the game. He came on in the 69th minute and he scored that equaliser with 92 minutes on the clock. And they still got another goal. Question four, who is the youngest player to score a Premier League hat-trick? Was it A, Chris Bart-Williams in April 1993? Was it Robbie Fowler in October 1993? Was it C, Michael Owen in 1998, February 1998? Or was it D, Nicholas Anelka in February 1999? The correct answer was C, Michael Owen. He was 18 years and 62 days old when he scored a hat-trick in a 3-3 draw. Scored a hat-trick and still didn't get the victory against Sheffield Wednesday back on Valentine's Day in 1998. Last up in the multiple choice round, question five, which team was not relegated from the inaugural 1992-93 Premier League season? Was it A, Oldham Athletic, B, Crystal Palace, C, Middlesbrough, or D, Nottingham Forest? The correct answer just was Oldham Athletic. Oldham Athletic and Crystal Palace both finished on 49 points in that season, but Oldham's goal difference was enough to keep them up. Okay, that's the end of the multiple choice round, the first round. Let me know how you're getting on in the live chat if you're watching the premiere today. How did you find that first round? Are you feeling strong going into round two? Let us know in the live chat. We move on to round two, which is the Who Am I round. 5 points available. I ran through a list of clubs that belonged to a Premier League player's career. You had to identify the Premier League player. The first one, Manchester City, Chelsea, Bolton Wanderers, Chelsea, Liverpool, West Brom, and Liverpool. The answer, Daniel Sturridge. Question two, who am I? I played for the following clubs in the Premier League: Blackburn Rovers, Newcastle United, Manchester City, Aston Villa, and Stoke City. The correct answer was Shea Given, Republic of Ireland, goalkeeper Shea Given. Question three, the list of clubs was Everton, Manchester City, West Brom, Aston Villa, and Sunderland. Who was the player who played for those clubs? The answer, Julian Lescott. Question four, the list of clubs were as follows: Manchester City, Birmingham City, Manchester City, West Ham United, and Burnley. It was another goalkeeper. Joe Hart was the correct answer. And question five, the list of clubs. Tough one, this one. Manchester United, West Bromwich Albion, then Manchester United again, then Sunderland, then made a move to Fulham, then to Aston Villa. Who was that player? The Premier League player was Kieran Richardson, who was part of the Manchester United title-winning team in 2006-2007. But prior to that, in the 2004-2005 season, he'd helped West Bromwich Albion actually survive in the Premier League. It was called the Great Escape, having been bottom at Christmas. So the correct answer for question five, Kieran Richardson. Round three was the What Happens Next round. We showed you five iconic Premier League moments, and all you had to do was tell us what happened next. Let's show you the first one, which was from the game between Chelsea and West Ham in April 2019. Chelsea were on the attack. Let's see what happened next.
Two double Chelsea's money. Hudson-Odoi. trying to put it on a platter for Barkley.
How's he not been booked for that? I will never know. He's taken out the steward from behind. Outrageous. So that was what happened next. Ross Barkley slide tackled into a steward. I believe, he said it was an accident, I believe him. Yeah, no, I do believe him. But if you wrote down that, sort of took out a steward, tackled a steward, something like that, then you get the point for that one. The second clip we showed you was from that big, big derby game, Aston Villa versus Birmingham City at St Andrews back in September 2002. Olaf Melberg with the throw on. Let's show you what happens next.
Villa's 15th successive season in the top division. And Mark Colchester, oh my word! Oh, what an embarrassment! I do not believe it. We have seen one of the craziest goals ever. Enkelman miscontrolled a simple back pass, the kind of thing that he should be in control of 100 times out of 100. And his mistake has gifted the game to Birmingham City.
Poor, poor Peter Enkelman. This is quite a common thing. People, like, they miss the ball. And it happens anywhere, any outfield player, it's fine, isn't it? It goes out for a throw and you give the ball away. There's a bit of a groan, but that's it. But for poor Peter Enkelman, in the biggest game in their season, in a big, big derby game like that, a Midlands derby, that was a bit of a disaster. They went on to lose 3-0 in that game. So it wasn't that goal that made them lose the game, but it certainly didn't help, did it? So the correct answer, Peter Enkelman missing the ball, bit of a gaff there, and the goal going in. Clip number three was from the very first season of the Premier League back in 1992, September 1992. Aston Villa versus Liverpool at Villa Park. Let's show you what happens next.
Teal let it run and he might have made a mistake. Rosenthal's going to score. Liverpool, oh, he's hit the bar. What a let off for Villa.
Hit the crossbar. I don't know how he missed that. Looked, maybe just pass it on the floor next time. I think he learnt his lesson. So the correct answer there was Ronnie Rosenthal, unfortunately, hitting that crossbar. That was the correct answer. If you got that right, you got yourself 1 point. We move on to the next clip, which was from the game between Man City and West Brom. Paul Robinson had the ball, looked to play a pass. Let's see what happens next.
Mike Phillips. Now, Earnshaw could get his first touch. Oh, Donner's put it in!
Robert Earnshaw, proper striker Robert Earnshaw, he desperately wanted that goal, tried to sneak it off him but wasn't able to. I'm sure Richard Dunn would have been happier if Robert Earnshaw had got himself a touch on that one, but the correct answer was Richard Dunn scores an own goal. And the final clip comes from Craven Cottage. Billy the Badger was up to something, but what exactly? Let's see what happens next.
Oh, Villa going to close in on the top four. It was about as good as the action got, really. And I think the referee not too happy. This could be the first booking of the game.
Well, the referee's been a bit of a spoil sport, isn't he? At least that was entertaining.
I've never seen a Badger breakdance like that before.
So the correct answer was that Billy the Badger was delaying the second half and had to be forcibly, and I don't use this lightly, forcibly removed by referee Chris Foy so that they could kick off with the second half. Round four was Connect the Dots. I asked you four questions. There were four answers there. And then the fifth question, which had 5 points available, that one was where you were looking to connect the dots. So let's start off with those first four questions. The first one was, which side scored the most goals over the past decade? The correct answer was Manchester City. 845 goals, and they scored over 100 goals in two separate seasons, 2013-14 and 2017-18. Question two was, which side went a Premier League record 14 consecutive matches without conceding a goal during the 2008-2009 season? The correct answer was Manchester United. Question three, which side went 86 home Premier League matches unbeaten between the years of 2004 and 2008. The correct answer was Chelsea. That was a run that lasted 4.5 years. It kicked off in March 2004 with a 2-1 win over Fulham, and it ended in October 2008 when Liverpool beat Chelsea 1-0. And question four, which side scored in a Premier League record 55 consecutive matches from May 2001 to November 2002? The correct answer was Arsenal. Arsene Wenger's Arsenal side scored 117 goals in that 55 match run, over 2 goals on average per game. Thierry Henry, of course, scored the most, 33 goals in 42 games during that period. So that's the 4 answers, but what connects them all, which gives you the answer to the 5th question and could get you 5 bonus points? 4 clubs there, but what do they have in common? The answer that we were looking for was that those are the 4 sides to have won the Premier League title more than once. Blackburn won the Premier League title in 94-95 and Leicester City won it in 2015-16. But those other sides, Manchester City, Manchester United, Chelsea and Arsenal have all won the Premier League title more than once. Okay, that's 4 rounds down now. This might be a time to pause the video, figure out what your scores are, see where you're at in the pecking order as we move into round 5. Also, get your phones out, get your cameras ready because I want to see some celebrations in a video form or in a photo form on social media using the hashtag PLPubQuiz. So get all of that ready. I want to see some selfie celebrations that we can shout out next week, okay? Get yourself ready, pause the video if you need to. If not, if you're ready, if you're good to go, let's give you the answers to the final round, round 5, the miscellaneous round. Question 1 was the Premier League faces question, and there were 6 points available here, 1 for each correct answer, be it the hair, the eyes, nose and ears, or the mouth and the chin. And if you got all 3 of them right, you're able to double your score and get 6 points. So, without further ado, those luscious blonde locks belong to Kasper Schmeichel, the Leicester City goalkeeper. So 1 point if you got that right. The eyes, nose and ears belong to David De Gea, the Manchester United goalkeeper. And you might see a bit of a theme occurring here. There was another goalkeeper when it came to the mouth and chin. Nick Pope was the final answer, Burnley's goalkeeper. So 3 goalkeepers there coming together to make one beautiful face. If you got 1 of those right or 2 of those right, you get 1 point or 2 points. But if you got all 3 of them correct, you double it up, you get 6 points. Big, big question there. Question 2 was our Fantasy Premier League question. The Premier League's FPL show host, Jules Breach, gave us that question and here she is with the answer.
Well, despite being the 8th highest scoring player in the game with 201 points, by game week 38, the most owned player in FPL was Sergio Aguero with 42.7% ownership.
Question 3, we showed you a quick fire clip. 5 goal scorers in around 5 seconds. Let's show you that clip one last time, then we can reveal the answers. 5 goal scorers that give you 5 points in this quiz. So the 5 goal scorers we were looking for, Wayne Rooney, Kevin Phillips, Harry Kane, Gianfranco Zola, and Marco Arnautovic. They were the 5 correct answers. If you wrote those down, well done. 1 point per answer, 5 points available in total there for question 3. Question 4, that was asked by Micah Richards, the Man City legend. He was asking us a question about his career. Here he is with the answer.
The only English player who's played more Premier League matches for Manchester City than me is Joe Hart with 266 appearances.
Thanks for that, Micah. So, Joe Hart was the correct answer there. 266 Premier League appearances, the most by an Englishman for Manchester City across 3 spells. If you got that right, well done to you as we move on and move into the final question from the final round. That's question 5, and of course, it is the spot the ball question. We showed you this image from the Leicester City versus Watford game in January of this year at the King Power Stadium. James Justin and Kiko Femenia, they're battling out for the ball, but the ball had disappeared. Which square was it in? We were looking for the right coordinates, and the right coordinates were 5D. Or D5, whichever way you want to put it around, that's absolutely fine. You get yourself 1 point if you got it right. 5D was the square on the grid in this week's Spot the Ball image. And that's the end of the quiz. Round 5 is done. Well, it's nearly the end of the quiz. It might be time to pause. Figure out how many points you've got here. Have you won? Have you beaten the person that you've challenged this week in the Premier League pub quiz? Maybe you have, maybe you haven't. But if you pause the video, make sure you find out and then come back to me because I've got the answer to the tiebreaker question. Because if you're drawing, we don't have draws when it comes to Premier League pub quizzes. You have to have a winner. So pause the video right now, count up your scores, figure out where you are in the pecking order when it comes to this week's quiz. and then unpause the video when you are ready for the tiebreaker answer. So here we go, the answer to the tiebreaker question. This might be a good time to record yourself. I want to see those selfie celebrations. Get them ready. If you've gone to the tiebreaker question and you still don't know if you've won or lost the quiz, record it right now and make sure you let us know using the hashtag PLPubQuiz. The question was this: Liverpool have scored the most penalties in Premier League history, but how many have they scored? Whoever gets closest to the correct answer gets the point, gets the W. The correct answer is 125. Every time, whenever I deliver the answer, I can hear the screams of pain, people falling to their knees or jumping for joy, and I want to see it. I want to see it on social media. Use the hashtag PLPubQuiz. Get your celebration selfies out there into the world. Get that flex on. Tell the people that you won the quiz this week. The best quiz in the world, the Premier League Pub Quiz. So until next Sunday at 6 p.m. where we will be premiering episode 5 of the Premier League Pub Quiz, I've been James Alcott, your host. You've been amazing. I'll see you next week. Have a good week.